The next thing we will do is to go to the Stasi protection and coordination in the study toolbar. Edit study case. In the edit study case, you can see the study case ID. Okay, this is the maximum number of iteration, the precision. Okay, I will keep it in the default values. So the study type. So the study type, we have three study types: single fault, load flow with no fault, and a sliding fault. Okay, so the simulation time is 5 seconds. I will select the single fault and the fault location. Select the fault location. Okay, this is the fault location. The location will be 50%. If you are selecting 50%, as per the relay configuration, it should come in zone 1. So the tripping will be instantaneous. Okay, the fault type, three-phase fault. Three-phase fault we will simulate. Okay, click on OK. Just one more thing. Make sure your device is selected from the protective device tab. Okay, now I will run the Stasi study. On the screen now you can see we have several values populated. So this is the voltages. This is the positive sequence, zero sequence, and the negative sequence. The suffix 2 is for the negative sequence. So here I have the positive sequence current, negative sequence current, and the zero sequence current. So in three phase fault, you can see both zero sequence and the negative sequence values are zero. The positive sequence value is the only one available for three phase fault. Okay, so this is the device which has operated during this fault. I will go to the sequence viewer. On the sequence viewer, you can see the time of operation. The zone 1 is set to be instantaneous, zero. Okay, but practically there will be a time. So this is 20 milliseconds, and the circuit breaker has operated at 120 milliseconds. Okay, I will close this. So if you want to change these values, I mean, if you want to change the display options, you can see these are the phase values. You can select phase values and see what were the phase values during the fault. Okay, I will select back the sequence values. So for the next case, I will change the location to 70%. Okay, this will be the same three phase. Okay, for the three phase, I will run the same study. Okay, and go to the sequence viewer. And now you can see that the time has changed. If you go to the relay configuration, the zone 2 time is 0.2 seconds. So 0.2 seconds plus 20 milliseconds for the relay. And then the circuit breaker operates at 320 milliseconds. Okay, so now you have the discrimination between the two zones. So when the fault is within 60%, then your zone 1 is operating and the time of operation is almost instantaneous. Whereas when your fault is beyond the zone 1, that is beyond 60% of the transmission line, your device is operating at a time delay. That is, it is operating after 0.2 seconds plus the time taken for the circuit breaker to operate. Okay, similarly, do the same. This case, we will do a line to line fault. Okay, the line to line fault, the time will be the same. You can see this is on zone 2. Okay, the time will be the same. Here, I want to show you this. Because when line to line fault occurs, you have values for both positive sequence and negative sequence. Zero sequence will be zero. I just want to show you this portion. And similarly, for your ground fault, okay, for your ground fault, you can see all positive sequence, negative sequence, and zero sequence values are showing up. Okay. And now we will check if the reverse zone is working. Okay, in order to check the reverse zone, I will select three phase. Fault location will be on this connection, that is on the bus. So this is my forward direction, that is bus 1 to bus 2. My reverse direction is from bus 1 to bus 4. Okay, I have selected this portion. Okay, now I will simulate the fault. Here you can see this circuit breaker has operated. We will go to the sequence viewer and the time of operation. Okay, for zone 4, you can see from the configuration, the zone 4, the time of operation is 1 second. Okay, so here we have discrimination between zone 1, zone 2 and zone 4. So because all of them are operating at different time intervals. Time here is 1 second and the time taken for the breaker is 1 second plus 120 millisecond. Okay, so we'll close this portion. Okay, now we have seen the discrimination between zone 1, zone 2 and zone 4, and similarly there is a discrimination for zone 3. So zone 3 is selected as 120%. So it is overreaching, that is beyond the transmission line, and the time TZ3 is 0.6 seconds. Okay, for zone 3, you could do it as an exercise. Just add a transmission line on bus number 2 and simulate a fault on the transmission line. So this should be reaching inside the 120% of the impedance, then this transmission line circuit breaker will operate and the relay will operate on the zone 3 with a time delay of 0.6 seconds. So it will be 0.6 plus 20 milliseconds for the relay to operate and plus 100 milliseconds for the circuit breaker to operate. Okay, one more study that we could conduct is the sliding fault. So here we have seen the study type. This is a single fault. If you go to the sliding fault and select in steps of 10, okay, then select your transmission line. Line 1, steps of 10, 3 phase fault. Okay, then you can see here you can see at 0% this device has operated. Okay, go to your sequence viewer. Okay, this is your sequence viewer. So we have a slider. Move the slider. You could see here the time is 20 milliseconds. So this is within the zone 1 of this distance relay. If you vary it beyond 60%, okay, now it is 70%. At 70%, you can see that the zone 1 is not operated. The relay has operated on zone 2 with a time delay of 0.2 seconds. Okay, so similarly, if you go to 100%, it is still on zone 2. Okay, if you want to check for zone 3, like I said before, add transmission line here, simulate a fault, then it should operate within the zone 3 region, because zone 3 is overreaching, it is beyond the transmission line. Okay, zone 4, as I mentioned before, it is the reverse direction and it is going from bus 1 to bus 4. Okay, now we will see the same, the zone 1, zone 2, zone 3 and zone 4 in the RX plane. Okay, to do that, just select your transmission line and go to the create star Z view. Okay, on the star Z view, you can see this is my RX plane and here you have the relay selection. So there is only one relay, just select the relay. Okay, this is the protection element selection. So these are the elements which are available in the protection relay, and I have mentioned before that I have only selected zone 1, zone 2, zone 3 and zone 4. So zone 1 extension, zone P and zone Q are disabled. You can see this fault locator is here because we have conducted the sliding fault study. If you are not conducted, then this will not show up here. Okay, so this is the RX plane. This is your transmission line. So this transmission line, okay, see, this is the primary. 46.58 is the impedance and the angle is 23.06. This is the same that we have calculated using the Excel sheet. Okay, now I will add my line 4 in the reverse direction. Okay, so this is my line 4. Line 4 I have added in the reverse direction. Okay, the zones, go to the element ID. Just uncheck, select your zones. Zone 1, zone 2, zone 3 and zone 4 I have selected. So these are all phase elements. Okay, phase elements I have selected. Okay, these are my zones. So this is my zone 1. Okay, this is the zone 1. This is my... Okay, this is the zone 1. This is the zone 2. This is the zone 3. And this is the zone 4. Okay, zone 4 you can see it is in the reverse direction. So all these elements are quadrilateral type. Okay, these are all quadrilateral type, and here you can see the state. Okay, the state is on. Okay, zone 1, zone 2 and zone 3. Okay, because the fault location is at 0%, all these three it will pick, but it will operate at different time because we have selected it to operate on different times. Zone 1 is instantaneous, zone 2 is 0.2 seconds and zone 3 is 0.6 seconds. Okay, that's why everything will pick, all three zones in the forward direction will pick, but only zone 1 will operate. Okay, now I am going to vary to 10%. Okay, these are all off. Okay, zone 1 is still on, zone 2, zone 3, okay, still on. So going beyond 60%, you can see that zone 1 is off because it has reached beyond the zone of the zone 1 area. Okay, so zone 1, it has reached beyond zone 1, the impedance is beyond zone 1, so it is now within the zone 3 and zone 2. That's why zone 2 and zone 3 has picked, and zone 3 will operate at 0.6, zone 2 will operate at 0.2. That's why zone 2 will operate first. Okay, that's the reason. So if you go till 100%, it is still zone 2 and zone 3 is picking. Okay, this is how you could determine which zones are picking during a fault. Okay, so if you close this, now we can do the same using line to ground. Okay, line to ground. Okay, go to your transmission line, select your transmission line, add your reverse element. Okay, reverse transmission line I have updated here, and select your elements. Okay, these are all my elements. This is the active relay, and select the ground elements. Okay, all ground elements are selected, and just plot it here. Okay, this is the zone 2, zone 3, zone 1. This is the zone 1. This is your zone 4 in the reverse direction. Okay, so you can see 0%. If you go beyond 60, zone 1 is disabled, zone 2 and zone 3 is picked up, and till 100%, okay, till 80%, you can see it is within this region. Okay, if you go beyond 80%, then zone 2 is off, state is off, and it's only zone 3. And if you go beyond 100%, then all the elements will be on off state, and the protection will be operating on the bus number 2. There will be a protection relay here, and that relay will be operating the circuit breaker somewhere around here to disconnect the line. Okay, this is how the earth fault element operates in the distance relay. So I have also attached the manual for the relay, that is a MYCOM P441. So this is the manual, P44X manual. This is from Arriva. So the Arriva was later acquired by Schneider. So the relay is the same, the setting groups, everything will be the same. And here you have all the details regarding the selection of different zones, the algorithm, the distance algorithms, the forward reaching zones, reverse reaching zones, power swing detection you could use using the zone P and zone Q. All the details are available in the manual for this relay, that is MYCOM P441. Selection of different zones, okay, the basic trip schemes, etc. So this manual is already attached with this lecture. You could refer to this manual if required. This lesson was based on the MYCOM relay P441. Okay, this is based on the Schneider Electric MYCOM P441. Okay, if you go to your library, you could see many other relays. Okay, so the basic parameters required to configure the relay will be the same. Okay, this will be the basic parameters required. However, for some relays, they will require many other parameters. Like in this case, this relay will calculate many parameters required from this value which we have provided. The other manufacturers will be a slightly different approach to this. Here you could see there is also a distance element here. Okay, so distance element here. Okay, here you have the Z1 mag, positive sequence, line impedance, magnitude you have to provide, zone 1 angle. Okay, so this will be slightly different, but basically it will be asking for the same parameters. If you are not familiar, you have to go through the manual of this relay and determine what parameters we need to configure for different relays. So here you can see the primary values we cannot enter for this relay, so you could only enter in 1 amps and 5 amps secondary. Okay, so you need to convert all your primary values to the secondary values by this CT ratio and VT ratio. That is, the Z ratio is CT ratio divided by VT ratio. Okay, so that's all for this lecture. I hope you understood how to configure distance relays in ETAP. So we will see like multiple distance relays in operation in the upcoming lessons. So that's all for this lesson, and I'm hoping to see you in the next lecture.